I don't think there's a cure for that.
It uses power for the good of mankind.
We could save dolphins.
And stop global warming.
And bring peace to the world.
There's so much good we can do.
Do you have anything for them?
Well, I'm not a mechanic, but how long has this been going on for?
Ever since I fell in love with your mom.
Thought you wanted to do good for mankind.
Yeah, but this is more fun. Now make out with the defibrillator!
Oh no! What are you doing?
What the?
So the symptoms are a weird empty sensation in my stomach, a feeling of lightheadedness, and an unusual amount of saliva in my mouth when I think of food. I checked on the internet, and apparently it might be something called the G-virus, which can only be cured by cutting off the infected part or the removal of the brain.
I'm gonna prescribe 2 weeks off and a couple of heavy sedatives a day for 6 weeks. No, that's for me. What you just described is called being hungry. Now, for the last time, please get out of my office so I can curl up under my desk and revise my career choices.
You treat him like a normal kid, not a charity case.
Go tell that to his head!
Well, I patched him up as best I can. But for the last time, I'm a nurse. I'm not a mechanic.
Well, I'm not a florist or a meteorologist or some kind of freak show owner. But you don't see me complaining, do you?
First, I was just about to get some medication because of...
Achoo. Right. Sounds like a simple allergy. Just hold it in and get back to class.
Oh, okay.
You should never hold in a sneeze. It's very dangerous. You could pop a blood vessel or even worse.
Is she right?
What she is a pain in the neck who makes my job a nightmare.
If you have a pain in the neck, you should really consult a medical professional. Because your vertebrae may have slipped out of alignment, which could be a sign of something more serious.
Oh, thank goodness. You need to help me. Bobbert's gone crazy.
Here you go.
What's that?
Tech support hotline. I am not a mechanic.
Oh, thanks! Aren't you supposed to take care of kids who are ill?
Have a nice day!
But we still don't know what he's allergic to.
Have a nice day!
I feel like you're trying to tell us something.
Have a nice...
I'll never know what she was gonna say now.
Dr. Simeon's log. The subject's state is now getting worse. The disease has distorted their faces into a hideous grimace.
There's nothing wrong with these kids. They're just smiling because they're happy. And for the record, you're not a doctor.
The happiness is the disease! And for the record...
Watterson. No, I haven't lost weight. No, I haven't done something new with my hair. No, you don't have the bubonic plague. No, you can't have a second opinion on that. Therefore, no, you cannot get a note to skip gym class. What was that?
Don't worry about it.
What's more important is that I respect you as a professional, and I commend you for your dedication to medical practice. And for this, I would like to personally shake you by the hand.
Did you just give me a quarter?
And there's plenty more where that came from.
Oh, I know.
Diseased! It's scientific!
That was a lot of things ending in ick. It was graphic, it was idiotic, it was sick. One could even say it was horrific. But it certainly wasn't scientific!
I thought that was fan-flubbin-tastic!
How does 1,000 cents sound to you?
$10?
How does 100 cents sound to you?
A dollar? If I just wrote you a note now, would you promise never to come back?
I swear.
Hey, that's an IOU.
Look at their eyes. They're all weird.
Maybe it's because you've been shining a flashlight into them for half an hour.
What, really? Look at those faces. Hello? Hello? Is anyone there?
Hello? Hello?
Your stomach and you'll be breathing out of your arm for a while, but apart from that, you're hunky-dory.
What? Where did you get your diploma? The Royal College of Ducks? Because you're a certified quack. You haven't run a blood test, taken a temperature, or even an
can you see what I see?
The cuddle monkey says it wants a kiss.
No. Stop that. No, don't do that. Let's get back. No familiar. Get back. No.
What are you doing?
Throwing water at them.
That's not water. It's cough syrup.
And that's not how you treat students.
He's fine. He just needs to walk it off.
I'm talking about me. I've been
in contact with these germ bags all day.
I can feel myself getting ill.
Like Monday, when you thought the foam in your mouth was rabies, only to discover it was toothpaste. Or Tuesday, when you thought you broke your leg, even though you don't have any bones. Or yesterday, when you thought you'd gone deaf because nobody had spoken to you for 5 minutes.
I had no other choice but to put the subjects in quarantine. Their state is deteriorating. I also resolved my difference of opinion with the medical staff. Research Supervisor Lucy Simeon, signing out.
Supervisor? More like a super nut job. I'm not gonna watch you torture children for being happy. I'm getting Principal Brown.
Sorry, Terry, I'm a nurse, not an artist. You're all going to the hospital now. I'll call the ambulance.
Eyes, I'm gonna give you all the change you want in your world.
Principal Maroon, no podemos ocultar más nuestro secreto de la simian.
Oh, nurse.
Caramba, hemos sido descubiertos.
Oh, hi, Molly. How you doing?
Like this?
No, more like this. She's giving herself all these titles. I mean, what is a senior mega consultant super virologist anyway?
In your face! Told you they were ill! Look at them!
Oh my goodness. The children!
Is that your idea of you, me?
I thought she would see the yellow rope, duck, slide in the oil, and get delicately trapped inside the box. I didn't think it would... Well, you know... Candle I put in the box in case they were scared of the dark. At least they're in the infirmary.
Miss Simeon, do you realize what this means?
It means you were wrong, and you were wrong, and I was right!
Mr. Cornet, your face, what happened?
Pretty mama, handsome daddy.
No, I meant your black eye.
You should see the other guys.
Hi, Mr. Cornet.
I cannot stress strongly enough, these are not the other guys.
What happened to your face?
Oh, I just walked into the cage and got hurt.
What? You got into the cage? Like, you're an MMA fighter? What's that?
Meaty men misunderstanding martial arts.
Nurse, we need a CT scan, an MRI, and an X-ray. Stat!
Right, and I want a six-figure salary, a cabriolet, and a pension plan. Unfortunately, this is a school infirmary, not NASA. All I have here is vitamin C, some teddy bear-shaped band-aids, and a couple of lollipops. What's the problem, anyway?
Our sister got infected by a social parasite!
Sounds kind of violent.
Only according to the so-called medical community.
Oh, Mr. Cornet, who would have thought you'd be so...
Oh, that arm feels a lot more withered than I thought it was gonna be.
Well, when you're fighting in the cage, the most important muscle is the heart. And right now, you're giving mine a workout.
Teach us.
I don't know.
Teach us!
Oh, sorry. So... what do we do?
Pretty simple. Your sister needs to let go of that poor girl. She is the parasite.
What?
Anais?
I'm sorry. I was really excited and I got carried away. I'll let go of you now.
Had a boating accident while trying to jump a shark on water skis. You've been unconscious for a few days. Do it.
I would say, in your face, if you had one!
I hope you can forgive me. I know I acted crazy, but it's because I never had a school friend before. So I got a little clingy. I think if you gave me a second chance and got to know the less insane, more normal me, we could actually be real friends. What do you say?
She went that way.
Violence is never the best solution.
What
nurse. She wouldn't even have a job if people didn't get hurt.
My alibi is watertight, unlike that boat the previous nurse was in. I mean...
Mr. Cornet, surely you'll fight if it means saving the school.
But to go back into the cage, I'm gonna need a whole support team. Even a medic.
I'll patch you up.
Please, Mr. Cornet, let's lose the formalities. My name is Joan.
Mine is Moonchild.
I'll stick with Cornet.
Fair enough.
I just want to warn you that, well, we did the best we could. Oh! It's not so bad. Oh, come on!
See? A perfect fit, and they're exactly like your old clothes.
Are words that have never been uttered in Lost and Found. Anyway, you're in luck. Mr. Cornet and I do ballroom dancing, and our costumes got shrunk in the wash, so this is all I got.
This is all you have?
Okay, this is all I have. Geez, since when were you so hot on grammar?
He means we can't possibly wear those. Without accessories.
Look, Mr. Cornet, I... Go get him.
Because I knew I was lying all along.
Wait, what?
I'm not a fighter.
I just lied because I wanted to smooch the nurse.
But...
Okay, I just need to sign these back in. Your name?
Watterson. Gumball Watterson.
Is that all one word or with a hyphen?
What?
Like Watterson Gumball Watterson or Watterson Gumball hyphen Watterson?
No. It's Watterson Gumball Watterson.
Like double barrel?
No, Watterson. Gumball Watterson.
Oh, so Gumball's your middle name.
Just forget it. Are you insane? Get out of the ring!
No. You saw what I did to that wall. I got this.
Was he talking about that wall the inmates dug a hole through?
Fight!
I think I'm feeling a little better.